In this video, we are going to take a look at how we can use the shell command to create a hollow cavity inside of a part. I'll begin by starting the shell command. It's located here on the 3D model tab in the modify panel. When I begin the shell command, it's automatically going to start hollowing out the middle of the part. As you can see, I can input a thickness value here. So if maybe I wanted an eighth of an inch instead, I can adjust that. You can see in the preview here that it's taking the original part and then it's going an eighth inch in every direction into the part and hollowing out the inside of the part. I can control the direction of the shell. These first three options here allow me to go to the inside, or I can go to the outside. Now the inside cavity is the size of the original shape and the thickness has gone to the outside. We can also go midway. So now it's halfway to the outside and halfway to the inside. For my example, I'm going to go ahead and go back to the inside option and click OK. As you can see, I've turned hidden lines on so we can actually see that cavity inside there. I could even do a section view to look inside there. So I'll go to the View tab, then Half Section. Then I will select a plane running through the middle of the part here. And now you can see that it has indeed hollowed out the inside of the part. I'm going to go ahead and undo to back that up. And in fact, I'm going to undo one more time to get it back to a solid part here. Another thing we can do is we can hollow out the part and remove faces at the same time. So back here on the 3D model tab, I'm going to start the shell command again. I'll input a thickness. And as you can see, remove faces is already selected. So I can simply come out here and select any faces that I want to remove from the shell. So in my example, I'll just click the top surface, then click OK. And as you can see, the actual top face has now been removed and all other sides have been offset in an eighth of an inch in my case. Of course, you can select multiple faces if you want. So if I start the shell command again and maybe want to select the top and the front faces, to create an open shape like so, I can do so. If your part has tangent faces, there's an additional option that applies. I'll begin the shell command again, and I will remove faces. Now you'll notice the checkbox in here. By default, this is turned on, automatic face chain. So while I selected this front face, since all of these surfaces were tangent, it went ahead and selected all the surfaces around the part. So I'll go ahead and undo, and if that's not what I want to do, then I want to turn that check off. Then I can go ahead and select a single face, and it does not pick the chain anymore. And now you can see only that front face has been removed. I'm going to go ahead and undo this and look at one more option here, and that's the ability to add unique face thicknesses. So let's say that on this part, I want all of my walls to be a quarter inch thick. And I want to remove the top of this part. But to give the bottom more reinforcement, I want it to be a half inch thick. So I'll begin with my shell command and I'll click the top face to remove it. Then I will put in my thickness. As I said, I want all my walls to be a quarter inch on this one. So you can see that indeed all surfaces are coming in a quarter of an inch. Next, I'm going to select the More button here, the two arrows. That opens up the unique face thickness section. I'll click to add a face. In this case, I'll select the bottom face. Then I can specify a unique thickness for that face. So in this case, I will go half inch. Now I can click OK to accept it. And as you can see, all the side walls came in a quarter inch, but I have a unique thickness of a half inch on the bottom of this part. So to create a hollow cavity in your parts, just simply use the shell command, specify some wall thicknesses, unique thicknesses if needed, and then select the faces that you want to remove from the part. That concludes this look at the shell command in Autodesk Inventor.